All right, guys, welcome back to another episode. I'm your host, T.
Tasha.
And welcome to the adventures of TNT. So if you've been following us for the past few days, we've been reacting to 60s music. And it's been an interesting journey it's been very fun. But we've learned some things about their 60s style of music. We've learned some things about the guys and the girls.
What'd you learn, babe?
Well, I learned that the guys are very smooth. And and not to date girls that are runaround suits.
That's all you got from it.
Yeah, so one artist that I wanted to check out was Ronnie Spector and the Ronettes.
Okay.
Because recently Ronnie Spector, she had passed away. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm not familiar with her at all.
Okay.
I do know that song, Be My Baby.
So you familiar with her music a little bit.
With
so
her music.
So you can't say
but
with her
so,
at
so,
all.
So, all right. Well, this is the thing. I think a lot of people have heard that song, Be My Baby, because it's a hit. It's a huge hit.
Mm-hmm.
They, especially our generation, they've heard the song.
They just don't know who she is.
Who she is, who the band is, or anything.
Okay.
You know, there's nothing to connect it to that, other than maybe a movie or something like that. And so when she had passed away and I seen that a lot of stars and celebrities were like, oh, it's very unfortunate and da-da-da-da-da, mm-hmm. I was like, you know, who is this person? And so I kind of wanted to look into that and learn a little bit more about her and the band. And one way that we can honor artists is by listening to and keeping their music alive.
Yes.
And so I wanted to check out this video of her explaining who the band is or how they got together.
Okay.
But then the song we're going to be reacting to today is Walking in the Rain. So let's go ahead and jump right into it.
Why do birds sing so gay? Well, first of all, that song means absolutely everything to me because that was, I think, the start of my wanting to sing. Because when I was young, I always wanted to be a tap dancer or a ballet dancer. I don't think singing was actually on my mind, really, until I heard Frankie Lyman. You know, we didn't know how to break into this business.
Oh.
And the peppermint.
What? Don't give me that look, baby.
Okay,
we're
going to have
to that's why we on this reaction journey. I'm discovering music.
Wow.
And because I'm pretty sure there's some artists that I know that you don't know about.
Yeah, but I know who.
What did he sing?
She just sung what he.
No, what song do you know that he sung?
I'm going to pull it up. We focus in on Ronnie right now.
I put you on the spot. Okay, don't play me, girl.
I'm not playing.
Whatever.
You want me to actually sing it?
If you can.
No, I ain't going to sing it. Because his voice is really high. Like, his voice is, when you hear him sing, you're going to realize why I didn't sing the song.
Okay.
But she just, in the beginning, sung a little bit part of his song.
Okay. All right. Well, I was asking you, but.
You want me to sing it?
No, don't. We're focusing on Ronnie right now. Shane.
Shane what?
Shane.
I think he sung
Why Do Fools Fall
and we all went to, we went to Camelucci Studio, which was like.
No, what are you doing? We're in the middle of reaction.
Well, we need to know some stuff.
Oh man! All right, y'all. Hey, I'm not editing this. This is real time.
Yes.
So I don't know who Frankie Lyman is, and Tasha, you trying to pull my card?
I didn't try to pull your card, but at least you would have known his face.
I seen his face from the thing, but I've never listened to his
music. So, he did sing Why Do Fools Fall in Love, so I was right.
Okay, all right.
But you've never heard that song?
No, it's vaguely in my mind.
So, I think we...
What about the Ooh, Baby, Baby? I see that
Ooh,
on there.
Ooh, Baby, Baby.
Oh, that was Smokey Robinson.
Oh. See, I didn't have to pull your card. You just pulled your own card.
All right, anyway.
Babe.
Well, let's get back into this. Let's take it back. Ugh.
So when reactors say, I've never heard that person or that song before, they ain't lying.
All right, let's go.
On my mind, really, until I heard Frankie Lyman. We didn't know how to break into this business. And the Peppermint Lounge was very hot. And we went to Camelucci Studio, which was like on 45th Street, so we knew exactly where the area was, knew exactly where it was. So me, my sister, my first cousin, we all dressed alike, put our hair real high, and my mother said, make sure you put cigarettes, you have cigarettes in your hand when you get online, because you had to stand online to get in that place. I, my mother didn't know we smoked anyway, you know, but we didn't tell her. We were very happy to do this, you know. And we stood there, and the manager came out and said, girls, you're late. And I said, don't say anything. We went inside. And that was, but we didn't do any singing when we first started. It was all dancing. They just said, girls, get up on stage and see what you do. Because we were on bars, as I said before, dancing. They said, that's because it was three Starlighters and three Ronettes, three guys and three girls. So they said, let's see how it will look on stage. And I think I grabbed the mic from Joey one night, and we were just playing around. And they said, keep that in. Not only did you see older people, you saw older stars. I'm talking about, I'm standing, I will never forget one night, I'm on the banister, right, just twisting away, and in walks Charleston Heston. You know, people like
that.
You know, and there's Edward G. Robinson sitting over there watching me dance. You know, it's freaking me out because this is what we watched in the 60s on the Late Show. We were watching, you know, these kind of people on, you know, and these Ava Gardner walks, and these are the kind of things that are, that were freaking me out as a kid.
The Peppermint Lounge. So why did her mom tell her to put cigarettes in her hand? Just to make her seem older or
yeah,
something?
Yeah, to make them probably seem older and more mature.
Okay.
You know, so that was cool. I like hearing how groups start and you know, do stuff like this because it sounds like an adventure.
It's definitely, you know, an adventure. Yeah. And the Peppermint Lounge, I want to look that up.
Yeah, so we'll probably do another video where we'll check that out because obviously the Peppermint Lounge was probably like one of those spots like, what was it, in California, Sunset Strip or something, mm-hmm. of where all the musicians would go because mm-hmm. they want to get discovered and, yeah. and noticed and stuff. So we'll have to look
into
that.
Where do you go now? YouTube.
Yeah, YouTube. it's crazy because they don't have actual bars and clubs and places mm-hmm. like that where artists can perform and get discovered. Now everything is just you get discovered mm-hmm. online. So
yeah.
It's crazy. But let's go ahead and check out an actual song from the Ronettes. This is Walking in the Rain. Let's go.
I love the hair.
Somewhere
distracting, so I had to stop watching it so I can focus on the lyrics.
Yeah.
And I loved her voice.
Yeah.
And it was so powerful, but yet controlled. And it has a doo-wop feel. Is this considered doo-wop?
This was probably during the time when doo-wop was really popping, because this was 1964, so Motown, a lot of R&B bands were coming around, and so this is the style that they probably were doing. Now, I thought this was a very beautiful song, very emotional, something that I think is kind of reflective with the other songs that we were listening to. Mm-hmm. They're the love songs.
Mm-hmm.
They're talking about relationships, getting a girl, you know, or being brokenhearted or dumped or something like that. And so it just lets me know that during this time, a lot of the artists were making love songs.
Because everybody wanted to be in love.
Yeah, everybody was falling in
love. And if you're not falling in love, you breaking up.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
You singing about it just like this, walking in the rain.
Right. Yeah,
you
know? Yeah. So that was one of the main differences between the songs, the previous songs that we listened to and this one. The other songs were kind of like dance songs. And even with the Runaround Sue, it was about being brokenhearted or dealing with a girl who was running around. But he still did it in such a way that you could dance and move your body to.
Mm-hmm.
With this one, you couldn't really dance to
you
it.
You can just
you can sway
do this.
To it.
But you know,
it is one of those songs that will get you in your feelings.
Yeah, definitely. And I wanted to know how old they were, because like I said, her voice was very powerful and controlled, but she sounds older than she looks.
Yeah. And even with that, watching the interview and then listening to her sing, I instantly start thinking about artists who I could tell were probably influenced by her. And one of those artists is Amy Winehouse.
Oh!
Amy Winehouse had the same kind of vocal style as Ronnie Spector. So I thought that was
interesting,
really cool.
Because you remember Amy Winehouse, she would have the beehive hair.
Ooh, yeah.
The makeup.
Oh, the makeup, the same style. Wow.
Everything.
Wow.
Interesting.
Dang. So that's the cool thing about doing these reactions to old school is that you can hear and find out who some of your favorite artists are, or your current artists or previous artists, late artists, who influenced them.
Well, not just the late artists, like current artists now.
Yeah, well, that's what I meant. But Amy Winehouse, she died, so, you know, she's a late artist.
No, I was just saying, like, artists in general.
Yeah.
Like, because even with the America Tour Highway, Janet Jackson sampled the music.
Yeah.
And so going back, like you said, you can see what they were influenced by, but realize that a lot of this stuff isn't original. But I don't think I've ever heard anyone like cover this song or anything like that. It probably would be like really hard to do something like that.
From what we've listened to now, it seems like people have covered 60s songs and they've kind of modernized them. But listening to these original songs in the 60s, there's still a certain feel
definitely
to it. And even listening to this this doesn't sound like this is a remastered version.
No.
This sounds like this is like the original version, because it still sounds kind of cloudy
like
and muddy.
Like it's on a record.
On a record.
Yeah.
Right. It's still, because of that, it still has that
authenticity.
Yes. Yeah, that weight.
Yeah.
That you can't duplicate if with a remaster.
Well, because with the remasters, like, it might be taken out, you know.
They clean it up.
Yeah, they clean it up. Right. And so a lot of things you might miss.
Right.
You know, but I'm interested to learn more about these ladies.
Right.
Yeah,
leave your thoughts and comments down below in the comment section, y'all.
Yeah.
I think that we would probably like to continue our journey with the Ronettes and explore some more of their music. And of course, if you have any thoughts about some of the things that we've talked about over these past few videos in the 60s, leave your thoughts. We would love to hear them. We love reading your comments. And of course, if you're new here, subscribe to the channel. That way you can follow us on our journey with this music. And stay tuned. We'll be doing our podcast this Friday, in which we're going to be talking about everything, all the songs that we've reviewed for this week, as well as some of the other things that have been going on in the 60s. Yeah. We also want to know more about the Peppermint Lounge. So if you're familiar with that, yeah, let us know.
Oh, and guess who else we need to learn about?
Oh, yeah, Frankie Lyman, right?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Now, you know, what's that guy from Power?
I don't know.
He had his brother in the show too.
Yeah. Lawrence Tate.
I think he played him in a movie.
Okay.
So, yeah. I think we should actually
we'll have to check it out.
Yeah. Cuz I think when you hear it, you'll be like, oh.
Okay, yeah, it's one of those guys. Yeah. Okay, all right, cool.
Yeah.
All right, guys, well, that's going to do it for our show today. Yes. As always, subscribe to the channel, like, and share, and we'll see you next time. Peace. Bye.